Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at how to get rid of the dashboard. So I love the dashboard. I love dashboard widgets. I love the idea of having these cool little apps that you can easily get to that can do these tiny little tasks. But in reality, I never use them. Never. Like year after year, never use them once. Matter of fact, the only time I ever see the dashboard is when I accidentally bring it onto the screen by hitting the wrong key on the keyboard or a gesture on my trackpad. So it kind of makes sense that I have to give it up and just get rid of the dashboard. So before we completely get rid of the dashboard, let's look at some lesser measures we can take. If we go into System Preferences, there are some things that we can turn off that make it easier to deal with. For instance, if we go into Mission Control, we can turn off Show Dashboard as a Space. Now, with it turned on as a space, I can very easily use three fingers on my trackpad to move over and see the dashboard, and three fingers go back. I can also use this keyboard shortcut here, F12, to do it and bring it up. So I can disable both of these very easily, and now I no longer accidentally see it. See, I can't go over there and hitting F12 doesn't do anything except generate a beep. So that kind of solves my problem. What it doesn't completely solve is getting rid of the dashboard itself. If I go into Mission Control, I see that it's not there because there's no longer a space and there's no way for me to bring it up. But I could still bring up dashboard. But I could still bring up dashboard using the dock item here at the bottom. So I could still get to it, which is kind of nice. Now, all of these are tiny little web applets. And the thing about them is they all use a little bit of CPU power. Now some people complain that they use a lot of CPU power. I don't see it. I use my Mac for tons of stuff and I kind of ignore the dashboard and I don't really see these taking up much. But if you never use them, it may be worthwhile getting rid of them. One simple thing you can do is to hit the minus button here at the bottom and simply remove ones that you don't need. Matter of fact, you can just remove them all and then they won't be running. Then dashboard really shouldn't be using any CPU power once you get rid of all of the widgets, and then you can kind of leave it at that. But there's a more extreme measure you can take. You can use a terminal command to actually disable the dashboard so it's not even running. So the terminal command isn't too long of one. I'll put it there, but I'll also put it in the show notes on this page at macmost.com so you can just copy and paste. And when you execute this single line here, it basically changes a preference saying to not launch dashboard at all. Now, nothing's going to immediately happen because the dashboard's part of the dock and the dock is still running. So it just has a preference to not launch dashboard next time. You can force it to go away right now by using kill all dock. And now you can see it kind of restarts the desktop and the dock there. And now even if I tap on this icon here in the dock, nothing will happen because dashboard is gone. So I could actually at this point just lift up the dashboard icon and get it out of the dock, and that removes everything. It's not here, there's no keyboard shortcuts for it, there's no gesture for it, and it's actually not running. And if you were to just jump right to doing this, I would still go into preferences and disable the keyboard shortcut and disable the its presence in Mission Control just to make sure, just to be clean so that it's not trying to activate the dashboard even though it's not there. Oh, and after doing this, if you decide you do want the dock, the dashboard back, you can go over to this and use no rather than yes and then do kill all dock again, and it changes the preference back to no, don't disable the dashboard, and when you restart the dock, it's back. I think one of the reasons that the dashboard is less relevant today than it was when it was first introduced is because of the iPhone and the iPad. And a lot of users have smartphones right with them that have apps that kind of take place of the things that are on dashboard. You want a quick calculator, you want to look at the news really quick, something like that. You can do it with your mobile device, so there's no need to interrupt what you're doing on your computer. Just use the app on your iPhone. So I hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.